Stay tuned for the latest message excerpt from josephprince.com.
So stop being a believer that's led by your senses, for we walk by faith and not by sight. And watch this. One night, Abraham was asked by God to come out, number the stars, which is tell the story of the stars again. And then, this is now very logical, when God says, at the end, he was tearing. God said to him, the story that he read the same gospel story, and one of the constellations shows him on the cross. And that's why we have Southern Cross up in the sky. Do you know there's a cross in the sky? When mariners were lost at sea many years ago, they don't have the instruments that we have, the modern equipments. They look up to the night sky, and the Southern Cross will lead them home. When you know where is south, you know where is north. You know where's the direction of your location already. Even though the vast ocean, you can't tell where's front, back, north, south, east, west, but the Southern Cross will lead you home. The cross will lead you home. Can I have a good amen? So God designed it every, and he saw it and he cried. And God, you know what God told Abraham? Abraham, this is how your seed, the one I promised, is going to be. Jesus Christ. They will come through Abraham's seed. All right? Thus, your seed will be. And the Bible says Abraham believed God and God imputed it to him for righteousness. So Abraham believed the same gospel you and I believed. Not a different gospel. Are you with me so far? Now watch this. Still no baby. Right? Then Abraham told God, you know, look, you gave me no heir, and the one that's born in my house is my heir. Then God told him, no, right? That's when God told him the stories, but there was still no manifestation. Now watch this. Something happened when God told him to look at the stars. At the same time, God promised him, your descendants will be like the stars. And now, the first part was quality. The story is quality seed. Our Lord Jesus Christ. Nice quantity. That's how many children you will have. All of a sudden, the stars change faces and they were screaming, Father Abraham, Abba, Abba, so many stars, right? If you go to the Middle East, especially in the Dead Sea area where Abraham was, near that area, if you look up, all right, the stars are amazing. When there's no light anywhere, the stars are so numerous, you can't even count them. Even today, with our telescope and all that, with all modern technology, we still cannot number the stars. And the Bible says, in the same phrase where it says God heals the broken in heart, in Psalms, He counts the number of stars. God counts the number of stars. He knows the number of hairs on your head, and He heals the broken in heart. Imagine God putting these verses together. The one who counts the stars heals your heart. He's not so high and mighty that He cannot come down to your level. He loves you more than anyone can ever love you. Friend, you think that you do not know, no one else knows the struggle you go through. It is too shameful for you to share. It is too private, whatever. But He knows. But best of all, He knows the way out. He knows how to bring you to that place of deliverance. He knows how to bring you to the place of abundance. He's the good shepherd. When He's your good shepherd, He will always cause you never to be in want. He will make you lie down in green pastures. Amen. Abundance all around. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. Come on. Come on, church. So, now watch this. God changed what? When God, He saw the children screaming out, Father Abraham, Father Abraham, what happened to His heart? His heart began to be filled with children. Doesn't even have one child. Doesn't even have one kid. But His heart began to be filled. He looked around. Oh, Father Abraham, Father Abraham, Sarah, we're gonna be parents of multitudes. And he looked around and his heart was being changed. Let me tell you something. God never changed His name until God changed His heart. Because you got to believe before you speak. So God filled His heart first with children. Whatever you're believing God for, you're believing God for a breakthrough in your business, you're believing God for a family that is more harmonious, more blessed than it is right now. You don't like to come home because you find there's a lot of strife at home. Well, you know what? Faith can change that. If you go by God's way. So God changed His heart before God changed His speech. Because in Genesis 17, after the stars, His heart was meditating on the stars much earlier for 20 years. He started meditating on the fact. His heart was filled with belief that he's going to be a father, then God changed his mouth. Now call yourself differently. You know when God did that? Genesis 17, which is many years after God showed him the stars, which means God changed his heart and he had to meditate on it. He had to meditate on it, meditate on God's promises. What are you meditating on? The report of the doctor? What are you meditating on? Amen. All the things that your boss said to you, all the things that your so-called opponents are saying to you. Amen. What are your critics are saying to you? Are you listening to those things? Are you listening to the report of the world? Whose report will you believe? Who has believed our report? We will believe the report of the Lord. Can I have a good amen? So God changed his heart. And then Genesis 17, 1 year before Isaac came. Think about it. 1 year before Isaac came, God changed his mouth. And God says, from now on, your heart is full of belief. Now, change what you are saying about yourself. Don't call yourself Abraham. Call yourself Abraham, which means father of many. And Sarai will be changed to Sarah, which means a queen, a princess, a mother of multitude.
This excerpt is brought to you by josephprince.com. To get the full message, visit josephprince.com.